LEDs are used in almost every electronic device we use today. Let's take a look at how LEDs work, why they're used in so many electronic applications, and how we can use them in our own projects. LED stands for Light Emitting Diode. If we were to zoom way in and take a look at the molecular level, we would see a P-type material and an N-type material. Where these two materials come together is called the P-N junction. When we connect our LED to a power supply, we generate electrons on the N-type side and holes on the P-type side. If we keep increasing the voltage, an electron will jump over and pair with the hole, and the process releases a photon of light. Now it's time to make an LED light up. For this simple circuit, we are going to be connecting an LED to a voltage source through a resistor. Unlike some other electrical components, polarity is important when connecting an LED, which means it only goes in one way. Looking at an LED, we can see that one leg is going to be longer than the other. The longer lead is the anode, the positive side, and the shorter lead is the cathode, the negative side. So when we put the LED in our circuit, we want the long lead to connect to the positive side of the power supply. LEDs come in a variety of types. There are single color LEDs, and then there are RGB LEDs that have three individual colors in one package. RGB LEDs have more leads than their single color counterparts. There are normally three anodes for each color, red, green, and blue, and one lead that acts as the cathode. But make sure you check your LED's datasheet to verify your pinout. If you watched my previous video about the resistor, you'll know that if you connect an LED directly to a power supply, it will burn out. This is because we need a resistor in the circuit to limit the current that flows through the LED. To do this, we need to look at the LED's datasheet and do some math, but don't worry, this is going to be easy. First, we want to look for two values in the LED's datasheet. This is the forward voltage and the forward current. The forward voltage is the voltage required for the LED to turn on, and the forward current is the current that the LED is able to sustain without burning out. We can use this formula to calculate the desired resistance value. Source voltage minus the forward voltage of the LED divided by the desired LED current. Let's fill in the values we found from the datasheet and plug these into our calculator to define the desired resistance of 90 ohms. But no one wants to do the math these days, so I've included a link below to the DigiKey website that has a nice LED resistance calculator on it. When dealing with RGB LEDs, you will need to connect a resistor to each individual color and do the resistance calculation separately, since each color has a different forward voltage. If you want to make the LED dimmer, just increase the resistance value. We sometimes want to use more than one LED in our circuit, and we can do this by hooking them up in series one after another. LEDs are awesome. They are small, power efficient, and bright. And I can't wait to see what projects you build using our friend, the LED.